The INC denies it is out to topple the Aquino government. According to lawyer Ferdinand Topacio, a member of the INC, their demonstrations are peaceful and they do not intend to bully or resort to any form of violence. Topacio asserts INC members are merely exercising the right to free speech, pointing out that Justice Secretary Laila de Lima seems to be sowing discord among their membership. Lawyer and INC member Ferdinand Topacio is now on the line for more on this. Good afternoon, attorney.
Yes, good afternoon, Sir Alvin. I'm Caroline. The blessings of the Father be upon all of you.
Same
Thank
to you,
you.
Sir.
Let me ask the question. What is the end game here, attorney?
Actually, I wish to clarify that I did not speak for the church administration. I speak for myself as an ordinary member. Well, we have been told to participate in this mass action. We have been told the reasons, therefore, and I fully subscribe to these reasons. As to the end game, or whatever you will call it, this is a form of peaceful protest. We will be protesting until our grievances are heard, as we have the right to under the Constitution to peaceably assemble and petition the government for redress of grievances.
And what do you say to the deluge of criticisms last night and until early this morning for those who were stuck in traffic because of the mass action? Of course, I'm not saying that you don't have any right. You have all the right to do that because there's freedom of expression. But what is your reaction to the deluge of criticism against your group?
Well, our people must know that in any exercise of a peaceful assembly, there may be some inconveniences that will be entailed. Mm-hmm. For instance, if there are people rallying in EDSA 1, EDSA 2, traffic also was at a standstill. Mm-hmm. In matters of faith, when there is the Black Nazarene in Quiapo, there is some inconvenience. But you do not hear us complaining because we understand that these are legitimate expressions and exercises of the freedom to peacefully assemble, whether for civic purposes or for religious purposes. So we beg the indulgence of our countrymen. The Iglesia ni Cristo is known for its orderliness. We have marshals there composed of the SCAN. And as stated by even the local city executives, traffic is flowing, there are lanes open, and there has never been a total blockage of the major arteries.
Attorney, as far as you know, until when will your group stay along EDSA corner Shaw?
The advice from our local, in my case, is for us. There are schedules for each local. Mm-hmm. One local corresponds roughly to the Catholic parochia. And there are schedules for each local to be manning these posts. So we will abide by the instructions of the church leadership with respect to these schedules and these activities.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Attorney Caroline Howard here. There was a
yes,
call
ma'am.
Supposedly from Senator Grace Poe advising de Lima to face protesters of the INC out there. Is that something you would support, sir, that call?
Well, Senator Grace Poe, and not only Senator Poe, but many others in public service, have called upon the government and the people to respect our right to peaceably assemble. Mm-hmm. And that's right, as I said, is enshrined in the Constitution. So we welcome that because there have been people who are trying to twist this into some sort of example, a power grab, which it is not, because it is not in our doctrine. The Iglesia ni Cristo has never been a participant in any power grab or any attempt to topple the government, because that is our doctrine. In Romans chapter 13, verse 1, we acknowledge that the civil government here on earth is ordained by God. So we will respect that as something coming from God. So we will not do anything to topple this government. Secondly, they're trying to say that we are trying to stop the DOJ from doing its job. We are not. We are protesting the way that the Department of Justice is doing its job, which is with a biased eye and an uneven hand. That is what we are protesting. We cannot stop the DOJ from doing its job because it has its mandate under the law. But it is also our right to protest the manner by which the DOJ is doing its job, which we feel to be prejudicial to our institution as a church and our religious faiths.
Binanggit niyo po, Attorney, na that there are certain localities or locales of the INC that will be massing up. Apart from what we're seeing today, which is expected to continue until tomorrow in Mandaluyong at least, are we supposed to expect more activities such as this happening in other parts of the country?
Well, as of now, we have no directive, as I said. Mm-hmm. I am not part of the church administration, nor do I pretend to speak for them. Mm-hmm. I only speak for myself as an INC member, and as a member, of course, of my locale, which is the locale of Better Living, Metro Manila South. Mm. So that is our ecclesiastical district.
But for any critic, perhaps, or observer who's actually watching this and would hazard the possibility that this might be a show of force, Maybe not in terms of efforts to oust government or any other member of the cabinet, but then a show of force for the INC, what would you have to say to that? And especially against members who have been expelled from the religious order?
Well, they have to realize that any peaceful assembly is a show of force. It does not even have to be the INC. Catholics, militant groups, the farmer sector, all of them must in government offices as a show of force to emphasize what they are demanding from government. What we are doing is no different. Perhaps we are better organized, modesty aside, and our numbers may be more, but that is no different from the exercise of demonstrations being made by the militants, by farmers groups or fishermen's groups or our indigenous peoples whenever they need to demand something from government. That is what we are doing. Now, whether government will accede to our demands or not, we do not know. But what we are emphasizing here again is that we have the right to do this. It is in the Constitution. It is not about stopping government, but exercising our rights. Precisely, the Bill of Rights is a limitation on the powers of government. Mm-hmm. We have the right to tell them, we think what you are doing is wrong. Please listen to us. That is all we are doing.
Sir, there is also a right, you said, to free speech and to expression, but government is also hearing it out, it seems. We are getting reports as well that Secretary Maro has, in fact, is already in a huddle with INC, members of the INC rally organizers, and talks are ongoing to arrive at the win-win solution to this ongoing, the differences that are on the streets now and ensure peace and order. What would you have to say to that, sir?
Well, I am happy that Secretary Rojas is talking to our leaders. I've always thought of Secretary Rojas as a decent and level-headed public servant. And I'm sure that with his good offices and with him at the helm of the talks on behalf of the government, a peaceful resolution acceptable to all concerned should be arrived at, and we can now stop this peaceful protest, because we really do not want to inconvenience anyone. We are not trying to bully or intimidate anyone. We are just trying to make ourselves heard, as is the right of every citizen of the Philippines.
Mm-hmm. But inasmuch as the call is for one to be heard and perhaps the Justice Secretary to also exercise fairness here and what you say is honor the separation of church and state, are you also personally, whether personally or for the church, calling for her resignation?
If you look at the banners there are no calls to that effect. All we are saying is that for the secretary to please take a second look at the way she's implementing or executing the laws insofar as the church is concerned. Because it is her belief, we have this feeling that she is exercising selective justice in the sense that with so many cases on her table begging for action, she had to put priority on an issue that sows division and disunity among our ranks. She appears to be personally interested in the complainants against the church, and she seems to be expediting these complaints over and above those which are of graver offenses, which are of bigger concern, like, for example, the Mamasapano massacre or the issue on the pork barrel. That is why this is what we are protesting, not that she is doing her job, but she is doing her job selectively and with favoritism.
Actually, I have a similar question, but let me ask it anyway. What will it take for the Iglesia ni Cristo to stop the protest actions?
Well, Sir Alvin, that is not for me to say. That is for the church administration to answer. And I'm sure that uh, what it will take has already been relayed to Secretary Rojas, and I'm sure that Secretary Rojas will process the request or the demand in his usual level-headed and efficient manner. So, we have confidence in Secretary Rojas that he can provide a peaceful resolution to this problem.
So the key here is the leadership, because based on what you're telling us, it appears that the members will just follow what the leaders will tell them to do.
Well, definitely. That is why there is a church hierarchy, there is an administration, and there is the flock, because that is also a part of our beliefs, that Sir Alvin, in 1 Corinthians 12, the verses 12 to 25, it is our solemn belief that the Church of Christ is one body, united, and with Christ as the head of the church.
Yeah.
That's why we follow what our leaders are telling us, because it is our belief that what they're telling us is born of divine inspiration. That is a religion. That is our faith. If others find that repugnant or repulsive or do not agree with it, that is also their right. But that is our faith. That is what we believe in. That is also our right to believe in our doctrine.
Thank you, Ferdy. Thank you very much, Attorney Ferdy Topacio, a
yes,
member.
Yes, Sir Alvin, Ma'am Caroline, thank you so much for hearing us out. And I hope your listeners and viewers will be clarified as to what our church really stands for. We are for peace. We do not want any confrontation. But of course, we have to exercise our rights, not only as Christians, as members of the church, but as citizens of the Republic, as Filipinos.
Attorney.
Thank you so much.
And God bless the Philippines.